Ebro in the morning, Laura Stiles, Rosenberg, and
New Year, first interview of 2015.
That's how you started off.
Now,
that's how you started off.
Crit is here. Give it up for Big Crit.
What's going on? Yeah, man. We here.
Crit, a couple things we're gonna deal with. Obviously, the new album.
All right, let's go.
I'm not gonna get into my problem with you.
Early
in the interview. That's not what we're gonna do. We're gonna save that till the end because your music and your rhymes and what you bring to hip hop needs to be respected first and foremost.
No doubt.
Okay. And let's start the interview. Let's start this interview. Because I would consider this show mainstream. Right, okay. You're like you're one of hip hop's champions, coming from the underground, building your way up since 2006.
It's a little bit before that, but
but people didn't know
2005. You know, first mixtape came out for real.
Got it.
But on a national scale, I feel like people started knowing your name really only 2010, something like that, right? Nine.
It depends, though.
When did you first come up here?
I mean, I first came up here in 2010.
So maybe 2008?
Because I started working with a lot of DJs around that time too.
Got it.
So yeah. Right,
so I want to focus on that, right? Because there's a lot of new artists. There's a lot of, I think, when Rosenberg put it very well, we were talking this morning, you're one of those rappers that haven't necessarily had hit records, but all the other rappers respect your grind and respect what you bring to the game.
Yeah.
How did you go about those relationships, and where is it, straight work ethic? How did Big Crit get where he is today?
It would definitely be a lot of work ethic. I mean, a lot of those artists had heard about my music prior to everybody else, you know, and just seeing me out and about, you know, working with Currency, Wiz, Smoke Dizza, and just being on the scene with production as well, because I was bringing that to the table too. Like, I can either rap on one of your songs, or I got these beats. And seeing me at the beat battles and the open mics and just making my rounds, and it was just one of those things that people really just, you know, saw my determination. And I think that went over. And then when I started to drop the content, they knew that I was coming from a place that was actually me. And it wasn't me trying to do no more or nothing else. It was like,
it wasn't no gimmicks, it wasn't nothing. You was telling your story.
I'm telling my story. And they knew that, so.
Talk about where you're from in Mississippi.
Yeah, Meridian, Mississippi, man.
What is that? You know, for us, I've never even been to the state of Mississippi.
Well, Meridian,
to start there.
Meridian, Mississippi is the second largest city in Mississippi. You know what I'm saying? It's also called the Queen City. And you got to go down there, man. It's important for people to at least go to Mississippi. You been to Mississippi, period?
Never been to the state.
Wow, goddamn.
I've never been to Alabama or Mississippi.
Oh, you're missing out. You're missing out, man.
Well, And I got people in Montgomery, Alabama, and it's always like, you know what?
Man,
Confederate flags and all that. I'm good. Why don't y'all come up here? It's
man,
more to do.
But shit,
it's 2015.
But they wearing Confederate flags everywhere now.
True. But they be at the state capitol out there, though. It be over the capitol.
This is what I will say, man. People get it twisted, but at least going down there, what you realize is if somebody don't like you, they don't like you.
Well, and that's why I wanted to know more about the South, right?
You know they don't like you.
That deep South that you're from is different than probably anywhere in the United States.
I mean, but
because it goes far back, and it's understood. And when people don't when people don't like you, they don't like you. If they don't like you because you're black, they don't like you because you're white. If they're in the KKK, whatever they're in, everybody knows where everybody's coming from.
But you got to also understand too that the thing is, people have seen what Hollywood has also portrayed, and normally the first thing that they talk about as far as Mississippi is the racism, and everything else is just ignored. That how as far as our background and blues and jazz and the counterculture and stuff, and Southern hospitality is real. People want you to see the positivity of where we're from, so when you go down there, it's open arms from people just waving at you, want to make sure you good. Especially if you come with me. And that's what I'm trying to express to people. It's like, it's not what you see on television. And until you go down there, you really won't understand the gravity of my music or who I am as a person and why I'm so adamant about, it's positive. We're educated. Like, there's a lot of constructive things going on. But you gotta bring that energy there, too. Artists completely skip over these states like Alabama, Mississippi, and Arkansas because they don't know no better. But they have fan base down there, and people go to the stores and buy their albums. They might not be connected to your blog sites. They might not be connected to Twitter and your social networking. But as soon as they see that post or that flyer, they go into the nearest Target, Walmart, Best Buy, and buy an album.
One of the main reasons I wanted you to come, and we're going to get into a song next. You pick whatever song you want us to play.
Cool.
Is because I wanted to I know Bannon. I've known Bannon for a long time, so I hear the stories, but I've never actually been myself.
Yeah, you got.
And I think that a lot of times, you know, people hear your music, but they don't necessarily know a lot about what's going on down there, like you said, other than what we see in mainstream media.
So, does it frustrate you when you hear people like educated people like Ebro, who within 40 seconds of mentioning the state of Mississippi, mention the KKK, yeah, as if that's raging at this moment every day.
It's not like that anymore. Especially, I mean, because, you know, now you have not
see,
only
but they just
networks,
hiding it, though. That's what it is.
But I mean, but then racism is hiding everywhere. Nobody expected Donald Sterling to just pop off and be like, you know.
You're right.
Like, so
I mean, I did.
It don't matter. It don't matter where you at.
Rosenberg has a thing where he'll go.
He's old and white.
87 and white. And you'd be like, yo, you're surprised he's racist. Yo, like, really? It's one thing if you're 27 and white. You'd be like, yo, you still on that?
It's everywhere, man. It's everywhere. So it's not just in the deep south.
I recommend, by the way, sorry, aside to this, everyone watch Bill Burr's new comedy special. He does a thing about Donald Sterling. And he's like, yo, the fact that he didn't say the N-word in that is the biggest surprise of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
He's like, it wasn't even that bad when you think about that, how old and white he was.
Yo, so listen, look, album Catalactica is on sale right now.
Okay.
Pick
Raphael,
a joint, man.
Raphael Sadiq's on the album. Yeah. Rico Love, E-40's on the
Woo.
Album.
Yeah.
Devin the Dude's on the album. Big Lupe Sun. Fiasco's on the album. Yeah. ASAP Ferg is on the album.
So you talking about respect from your peers.
Bun B, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, definitely. Mar Ruby, yeah. Yeah.
So what you want to get into right now?
Man, let's go with King of the South since we're talking about
Everybody
the South.
Everybody thinks they're the King of the South. All
right, man, but you definitely can't be a King of the South on Catalactica because I created a whole planet first off. All
right, fair enough.
And the way I feel is it's me, so it's all good. Grew up on the
countryside of Big time. Crits here, Ebro in the Morning, Lord Styles and Rosenberg. Now I'm ballin' on the city lights. Grew up on the countryside of time. Now I'm ballin' on the city light, King of the South, 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 grew up on the countryside of time. EMI cookie, my nigga, do it for the South, y'all know. Born and raised with them rubber plant, hang hung slave, grew up where you niggas won't go. Rip that shit like I own. I did a beat for my family, my homes. I got the biggest house on the block, born with a drop for them times I was out your homes. Car flow, time and time again, I try to tear these niggas. Do what they say of these niggas. Re-rock, old tap dance, do whatever for a sack, give a lap dance, bitch ass nigga. Beatbox, third coat, fella. 25 letters on my trunk, ain't shit changed. Rolling in the hams, image on propeller, leaning like a stretcher so clean. You think I'm out here selling cocaine? Light at the end of the tunnel. When you're flexing, it's hard to be humble. Talking fourth down, can't throw the ball a death jam. Cause they might funk. Kick that south flow that you can't get. Try to fuck the world, but my dick won't fit. My bitch like Chris, motherfucking Philly. You wanna be king, gotta claim that shit. I'm talking about all with they heads. When you put on a mink, gotta creep down the stairs. When you come from the country, your feet on the snakes, I make clothes out of fairs. I ain't playing no games. I leave for the future, you follow these lanes. I invited the side, the swain, the grain, the trunk with the pain, the goal in their mind. Grew up on the countryside of town. His name is Big Crit. Now, rest in peace to my dad, man. If I told my dad that there was an artist that started his own planet named after Cadillacs, he would be very excited.
Very true.
He would be very, very excited. He drove a baby blue Fleetwood Brown.
Oh, man.
So why Cadillactica, though?
Man, because I wanted to tell the story of where the Cadillac came from that crash landed on Live from the Underground. And for me, it was always important that all my projects actually mean something and tie some way into each other. And so it just gave me the opportunity, like, all right, I'm gonna create this planet. And it not so much be about Cadillacs, but just on this planet, is everything's a little obscure. Even some of the songs and just the sounds and just kind of trying to step out of my comfort zone.
That's right.
And I think I was able to, man, and then to tell a whole story as far as a lifespan on an actual project was a feat, but I was excited to be able to do the album, man, and for people to hear the whole story unfold. And then Lord knows where I'm going from here.
Lord Styles.
No, so you're cool with T.I., right?
Yeah.
So he doesn't feel a certain type of way for you having a song called King of the South, you calling yourself King of the South.
It's all good. Because, I mean, at the end of the day, I expressed that, first off, that's just how I feel. And I'm supposed to have that kind of confidence in myself.
Yeah.
And then to have dropped so much music and knowing I'm going to keep dropping music. And at this point, just knowing and being comfortable with, you know what I'm saying, just my talent as far as I'm good. And then knowing that I wasn't trying to disrespect any OGs.
Right.
And then even expressing that in the record was extremely important. You know, and so, but it's my movement and my mind frame, and on Catalactica, why wouldn't I be? So
musically, who would we be very surprised that Big Crit is a fan of? Like, what would, you know, musically, what is Big Crit that as fans of his would be like, wow, Crit's listening to that?
Man, that's crazy. Because technically, I'm always dropping obscure records that I always listen to anyway. You know, and normally people, I mean, definitely Adele. would be one. Who else? Dang, that's crazy, because I'm always naming people, so I'm trying to give you something that people might not.
So you're always trying to push people's musical palette into a different place. Yeah, to, like, yeah. I'm always taste buds.
Yeah, I'm always the dude. Like, I really like Def Cab for Cutie. You know what I'm saying? Mm. Like, these kind of people. Like, I'm you know, like, I like trip hop. Like, I be jamming a lot of stuff that people wouldn't even expect me to be jamming on my all time. And then back to the soul music, because that's what inspired me when I was younger, and so it still inspires me now. But definitely Kanye, still jamming Kanye. I love what Pharrell's doing musically, so yeah.
And what's your rappers, your top five rappers? Let's hear it. Top five.
My top
from
five
Big
rappers.
Crit.
I'm just going to say the rappers that I really enjoy listening to, because that top five thing is like,
it's too much.
It's open for debate. Yeah. What are you going to?
I definitely got to, you were talking about Bun B, would definitely be one. Scarface, no doubt. Definitely Pac, Andre 3000. Let me think. I gotta put these two cats in a group, A Ball and MJG.
Yeah.
So
you are definitely from the South, boy.
Why you gotta say boy like that? I don't know that.
I meant boy. I didn't mean boy.
I mean, the thing is that if you gotta understand, like, it's one of those situations where growing up they rapped about things that I could walk outside and see. It's no difference.
Well, no, and A Ball and MJG. Yeah. And by the way, I didn't mean that to say that to take away from any of the people on the list. I'm just saying it's literally that, you know, almost everyone you named, practically with the exception of 3000 and maybe Pac. East Coasters, people who are East Coast biased, wouldn't have named any of the other names on your
list.
Well,
those they shape that sound.
Yeah.
A lot of what,
especially
you hear
Spaceships
in Crim,
and like, you must love 8-Ball and MJG.
Yeah, but see, the thing is, a lot of people, they were sampling back then, but a lot of that was live instrumentation. Yep. So I had to learn that perspective of creating records for myself, because a lot of East Coast and West Coast was sampling music. Yeah. And I sampled, but I also was listening to these artists like UGK. That was original music they was creating, mm-hmm, that you thought was a sample, but no, it was somebody coming in there playing that bass line on that organ, you know. And so that gave me more as far as being well-rounded with production, because I learned how to have 808s and snare drums over live instrumentation. So, I mean, and then, you know, if you never really sat down and listened to In My Lifetime, you know what I'm saying, by A Ball and MJG, you might miss out on how lyrical those cats are.
Very.
You know what I'm saying? And so it's one of those things, like, you gotta go, you gotta listen.
Do you get frustrated by the perception of the South and hip hop by it not being lyrical, because you know that perception exists?
I mean, I express that most people have never really went to where a lot of these artists come from, or never seen their block. You know, it's not a vacation destination to go to Meridian, Mississippi. So if you've never been there, you have no want to go there. It almost transcends to my music. You hear my music and I'm talking about things that you probably are turned off by, don't even want to listen to. And so that also would have a part in what you think my lyrical content is, or how important.
Well, I think people see you as lyrical.
Yeah, I mean, but
I do think the South gets a stigma.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Of not being the artists that come from there, definitely, not always being lyrical. Because there's tons of lyrical artists. You just named a bunch.
Yeah,
there's a lot of popular ones now that get hit with the "they ain't saying nothing" tag.
Yeah, but everybody's using the same formula nowadays to make a hit record. And normally when you talk about a hit record, it's made to be simplistic so people can learn it. And it's not even rap music. It's just music in general.
Yeah.
You know, I think when it just comes to the South, and, you know, and maybe the bass heavy aspect, people have a opinion when it comes to it. It's like, oh, that's too simple for me. And it's just always the South. I have no, and that might be, again, them having no want to go to the South, and just how movies have portrayed people in the Southern mentality, mm-hmm, as to be slow, uneducated. And that's just how it is. And I'm trying to change it. You got artists like Killer Mike, David Banner. These people are
Run the Jewels is my favorite album right now.
And fantastic. We here, but this ain't the first time these kind of albums and this kind of message have been pushed. No. We've been pushing it.
Well, let's say something right here that is not going to be popular among the morons on YouTube. And this is coming from Captain East Coast Bias Underground Hip Hop. Me. The reason the South gets labeled with being simplistic, if it does, is because, like Crit said, hit songs are simplistic. I have news for you. Every hit is by a Southern artist. I got news for you. Everything else is by a Southern artist. The South has been running hip-hop for at least a decade.
It's been a while.
At least a decade. So when you look at the last 10 years of hip-hop, and you're like, oh, man, there's so much whack shit. Yeah, guess what? There's always mainstream whack shit. Over the last 10 years, a lot of it's coming from the South. But all the best music, not all, by the way, guys, relax, not all. But predominantly, the best music has also been coming from the South. Everything's been coming from the South.
I have to say that I feel you as far as South having hits. I can't say it's whack shit. But I feel as far as the South.
But some, you can't say some is whack shit?
But I will say this, that once people figure out a formula, and if you're a producer, you know what people want to hear. So, you know, you go to the rapper and the artist, you be like, oh, why would this artist rap? But as a producer, you know where the wave is going. And so you start creating within that wave. Me being the kind of producer, before I just be like, I don't like that artist, he always on some whack shit. I'm trying to figure out a way, how can I bring him into my world? How can I create a record that you probably be like, man, I hate that rapper, but that song right there is jamming. Because in order to be able to write a song, that takes a lot of skill.
What a lot of people don't know about me is most of the lyrical individuals don't make great songs, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And it's because they spend so much time focusing on just the lyrics and not the music.
Of course. Yeah.
The reason I like you is because I get both.
Yeah.
Right?
I dig it.
The reason I liked Outkast was because I got songs and lyrics. The reason I like Hove is because Hove allows producers to produce him.
Yeah.
He focuses on his rhymes and he gets other people to make the beats. A lot of artists that swear that they nice with bars and all that don't have a good production team to help them make the good songs.
Yeah, well, I'm here. I got you.
Well, at the same
I got tracks. I'm working.
But Ebro, don't double talk either. Because Crit could fit into the first category you're saying. He's super lyrical. He hasn't sniffed a hit yet. I'm sorry, it hasn't happened yet.
I mean,
but that's not double talk. I was just talking about my opinion.
Oh, for what you like.
For what I like.
A hit from what perspective?
The bullshit that I was just talking about.
You would be talking about what radio plays.
Yes.
That's what you're talking about?
Yes.
So why y'all don't play my record?
Here's a great
transition.
Great transition.
Great transition. My issue with you. Deani DD Digital, come to the stage, please. You said earlier today, why were you frustrated with Big Crit?
I was quite frustrated. I've been a fan for a very, very long time. We had you on Summer Jam.
Mm-hmm.
We supported you first.
Mm-hmm.
And you go to the other radio station, which is cool. I'm just a little bit confused on why you wouldn't want to promote your album here. Who supported you? That's what I'm saying. We all supported you.
Yeah, I appreciate that. But for one, when it comes time for schedules and I'm in the midst of a tour and they be like, yo, you need you to go do all of this here. I'm literally in the mind frame. All right, cool. Boom, 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 boom. And then I'm going to go do this show. So if it don't pop up, then I'm like, damn, did they not want to do that? Well, we trying to figure that out right now. Then I dropped a record called Mount Olympus.
Right, yes.
Nobody talked about that record up here, if I'm not mistaken. And then when it came time for other artists to come up here that I know might have heard that record, that question wasn't posed. I get asked about rappers all the time, and most of them I got real relationships with. But people never ask those rappers about me. And sometimes I'll be like, well, why? Well, why that didn't happen? Why that question didn't pose? And I dropped a record that was specifically made in a way that people are going to talk, and I saw people talking about it, but it wasn't talked about in certain realms where I feel like people are supposed to be neutral. So when it came time for me to drop my album, I looked at it from the perspective of, okay, I'm going to go do this. I don't know if these people fuck with me for real or not. I hope so, but I'm not against coming here, obviously, because I'm here.
Right. But we obviously fuck with you more than the other radio stations.
But see,
that's what I'm just
saying. I don't know what kind of... y'all got beef with all the radio stations?
Of course we do. No, yes we do.
But what I'm saying is that we totally supported you.
Yeah.
And when Mount Olympus came out, we talked about it.
Mm.
I remember...
But you can't be sure.
No,
you remember talking about it in the coffee room?
Was it on video in the
break room?
It was on video.
It was in the break room.
It is or it's not?
No, it's not on video.
Okay.
Oh, it was in the break room.
No, not on
that's a separate.
But it's on 97.com. That's what I'm saying. We supported it. We talked about it. We talked about paying attention.
Yeah, that's true.
When it came out, your album came out.
Listen, I'm gonna keep it real. I called you that day upset because I'm just telling you this.
Britt, you gotta understand. I'm neutral, bro.
I don't know.
I'm neutral, should do everything.
But I think as, like what Deani's trying to say. But you made time to go over there, but you didn't come here.
Yeah,
but we're the ones who've been supporting you from the beginning.
I dig that. But if you saw my schedule, I really didn't make time to do much of nothing before I had to go.
I'm just telling you this. That's
I'll just be honest with you. But, so it's like,
but just for the record, you know the song, how we just played your song a few minutes ago?
Yeah.
That is one more spin than you are ever going to get on the other stage. Because they're too busy corrupting the minds of people to ever play that.
And I'll be honest. I'll be honest. I don't feel no type of way.
Hey, thank you.
And that's only, and I'm going to tell you why. Because I always watch the trajectory of music in the game. Mm-hmm. And I know the politics and I know how everything mm-hmm. plays out. And I know you're a great guy and you love hip-hop music. So for us, and for me specifically, I knew you would come by when you had time, right? Would I like you to come by earlier and make us a priority? Sure. Mm-hmm. But you will make us a priority because you're going to need us because we're the only ones breaking motherfucking rap music, Ryan. So you'll come check us. I mean, you have to.
But in the same realm, I'm going to come back through with more hot shit. So I'm going to be here anyway because I'm going to be one of the people
and
that got
And here's
it.
The other thing.
I agree with that, too.
Go see everybody that wants to see you all the time. No, and that's,
no, that's sincere.
No, that's sincere.
Y'all got beef.
Listen, No. I'm serious. Promote yourself. I want everybody to embrace what you're doing because you're a producer that makes dope records.
Yeah.
And you got and you're an MC and you love hip hop and you always talking about cultural things and you're pushing music forward. So within the hip hop space. So I appreciate that.
No doubt, bro.
And you're a good dude.
Yeah, I'm doing good.
So I how she feels. She took it personal.
No. Can I just say one last thing in closing? Because be clear, because not everyone understands playing the politics and bullshit, which I don't want anyone to play. Yeah. Everyone should do whatever they do.
Okay.
I'm going to say this on Deonna's behalf. The reason I felt away is someone on your team, be it the label, be it your management, I'm not throwing a bullet. Mm. I mean, I don't personally think the label gives a shit about you. No offense. Sorry, guys. But in my opinion, someone dropped the fucking ball. Because you and I know that we've been homies. Mm. We've known each other for, I'm not saying we're best friends, known you for years, right? You've come up here 4 years ago before the other station knew what your name was, even though I know dudes from the South and likes to claim everything in the South. He wasn't fucking with your shit. So I actually break records, played you. I played you then. Oh, that's a blatant shot.
Yeah.
I'm the only person who really breaks records. So in my opinion, I always want people who rep the kind of culture that we love to make it a priority. Like, yo, we got to go see Rosenberg. He's the guy who actually plays music. And then as a result, to be honest, I feel a little fucked up about it because you're such a great artist. And this year, I sort of missed a lot of your shit because no one was hitting me about it. And I can't, I don't have the I don't really go through everything on the blogs with someone like you who's established. I need the shit sent to me. Like, yo, here's my new shit. Damn. Let's go. Damn, I just feel like we missed opportunities.
I dig it. But see, that's why we here. It's 2015.
Well, we're starting fresh. That's why I want to be totally blatant. I would never want to be upset. And then I tell you, I was a little annoyed.
And see, at this point, then you got to feel like, man, Crit just rocking and believe in music because it's not like I'm coming up here like, oh, I'm just 100%.
I never expect that for a second. Man. I know this, you got your schedule. You go do the shit you're going to do. I'm just saying, I want you to know, as people who believe in pushing the conversation of hip-hop forward,
no doubt,
we want to see you. We want you to be a part of this thing.
Well, I am, man. People heard it. We here. We good.
Yeah, so I just want you to understand where it comes from. It's all from a positive space.
What's my face say right now?
What, am I in building? I'm building too much?
No, you can build.
He's just like, hey.
Now, listen, that was great. We got to make room for Sin Santana. I'm just kidding.
Oh man. Yo, Crit, as we get you out of here, what song you want to get on for the people?
Man, so this is the last one?
Two out of the gate. That's pretty good.
I'm just saying.
How many you want to play? How much you think the people going to pay attention to?
Nah, they're going to pay attention to all of it
because
it's quality music.
Speaking of pay attention, you want to get to pay attention?
Man, you know what?
He doesn't want to. It was a great segue.
I'm trying to figure because you need to play more than one. But run, pay attention, man. Shout out to homie Rico Love. All right,
man. Yeah. Crit. Big Crit. King remembered in time. I saw that on his Wikipedia page.
Good job, Ebro.
No problem. Over here doing my research.
I should be paying more attention to you. I should be paying more attention to you. I should be paying more attention to you.
Smoking mirrors, dollar bills, flexing for no reason, get it how you live. Cracking seals, bottle popping on another level. Red light special, seeing selfish working with no discretion. Twisting, turning, my mind blown and the mind gone. She slow rolling, ain't no hoe in her time zone. Face right, stage lights, turn her out. Act like she's the only one in here that can talk for real, and that's without a doubt. Like, dang, dang. DJ run that back. I think that was a song. And she don't know how to act.
Crit, couple things before we let you go.
Yeah.
Tonight you're on.
Yeah, Fallon. Yeah, we doing
Oh, yeah, that's the Tonight Show, by the way.
Oh, yeah, I know. It's extremely important.
You did old Fallon. before, right?
Yeah.
But now
yeah.
you're doing the Tonight yeah, Show.
The Tonight Show Fallon with the homie Raphael Saadiq.
So oh, he's coming out with
yeah.
you.
Yeah.
That's super That's tight. Dope.
Yeah, so I'm excited love. About that, man. It's time. You know, people need to hear that kind of message as well. So I'm excited to do that record.
By the way, tell Ebro, I don't know if you know this.
Yeah.
You've also worked with another older, much older than Raphael Saadiq, icon in music.
Yeah, B.B. King, man. I got a song Word. With B.B. King.
That makes sense.
Yeah. The makes crazy sense. Thing, you haven't heard that song?
No.
I'm going to put you on.
It.
Crit,
that was on my last
put me in the
album.
Game, Crit.
That was on my.
Yeah, it was a while ago.
Listen, man, I listen to Crit. I like it. I don't yeah, study it. They study. Listen, man, you it's saw like, they caught feelings.
Yeah, man, but it's
they upset with you.
It's B.B. King, though, bro. It's, like that, no, no, that no. you just got to.
No,
it's
called, I will check it out. I didn't know right, about it. I'm so. Just saying, you have big fans here.
Yeah.
Who you've been giving the Heisman to yeah. for the last since the album came out?
You know what I'm saying? It ain't been like that at all.
Yo, you was hitting him with the Karate Kid. Nah,
not even, not even.
Yo, did you happen to see our interview with Azealia Banks?
Yeah, man. Yeah, she's definitely on a wave. She got a movement. She, you know, it's good to see somebody that just doesn't care about what people think and they just going for it. You know, no political curve about it. It's like she just, yeah.
Those were her emotions, raw emotions.
Yeah, man. You got to love it, man. Because that's what the art form is all about.
Do you feel any way about the music and like it going to a place that is potentially not good? Or are you happy with where hip hop's at right now?
Man, I feel like when it comes to what I do, I'm still fighting my own battles as far as being an artist and just being played and recognized and trying to get it to where people understand that it is something important in as far as subject matter and content in my music, to the point where I really can't judge and be so aggressive towards somebody else's content because I got my own battle going on. It's like, man, I'm still trying to make people go to my state, you know. It's bigger than just me and dropping a record off, you know, and that's what my movement is. So I can't really just speak on that, the whole Grammys thing and all that stuff, man. Lord willing that I'll just be able to put out music that's respected and people acknowledge it more and start to see. And that's what I'm all about. And that's what 2015 is about, is branding multi, you know, to the fullest. And, you know, Cal Latica is out. People can see the growth. You know, you can go to Target now and go get it. All my fans, shout out to the people that were supporting. And we out here, man. And that's what it's about for me.
Are you proud of what you're seeing around the Eric Garner and Mike Brown stuff?
Yeah, it's great to see people actually standing up, you know, for something now. It's important that we, as not only the hip-hop community, but just as human beings, we have to start saying no and, you know, stop. And for me, I never wanted to use hip-hop. Just because my album's out, now I'm going to take a righteous stand. And like, no, that's not what I'm about. Tragedy is tragedy. And I never wanted to use that in order to push my own agenda. That's not cool. And so I'm just glad to see a lot of people that don't necessarily do music, you know, standing out. And then the people that do speak on it, like the Talib Kweli, David Banner, Killer Mike, you can tell there's no alter, you know, like no
ulterior motives,
going on. It's just, this is them. And they're doing their research about it. And they get on CNN and they speak in a way that makes me extremely proud, not only to be a hip hop artist, but just a black man in general. And so, you know, I think people are starting to pay a whole lot more attention.
Well,
I think
on that note, we get into the Raphael Saadiq joint.
Yeah, man.
This is going on tonight.
Yeah, it's going on tonight, man. It's the record Soul Food featuring Raphael Saadiq.
His name is Big Crit, the album Catalactica.
Crit.
What happened to the Soul Food?
Nice meeting you, man.
Same to you, man.
Oh, wait, we met before.
We met before.
You said we met before.
Yeah, we did. We've met a few times.
Wait, hold on. when did we meet?
Well, the first time I came through here was about 4 years ago.
He did real late some reason.
Oh, you've been supporting him for 4 years? Damn.
Why you set you up?
Yeah, man. See, damn, man, it's like, crazy, yeah. And then I came through then. And then I've seen him at a number of occasions. But we was in Seattle.
Y'all talk all the time.
Yeah. but you know what I'm saying? It's an acknowledgement at the end of the day when I see the homie. And
of course. Y'all text?
It's crazy.
We haven't texted him in a minute. We have each other's numbers, though.
Because when I came here, I actually debuted. You know, the album came out.
Wait, we debuted an album for you before.
Yeah, you was around, but it's unfortunate you don't know any of the songs that was on that thing.
Yo, man. It's kind of unfortunate.
Jeez. You know, probably none of the records on this new album. But,
damn, man,
it's all good, though.
We started today, though.
It's 2015.
Hey, Meridian, Mississippi, Big Crit.
Yeah,
this guy's our
show. 300 block.
Yo, I want to big up to you on this album. This is like your, what, ninth album? 10th album?
Yeah, it's like 10.
10, man.
Yeah, we out here, man.
And Rosenberg, salute to you for supporting him for so many years.
I don't know if man. I'm not saying I championed Big Crit.
And that's
okay?
Why he's saying that, because he know like it's.
It was his Def Jam debut. I went hard for that. He's a great guy and a great artist. Man. I just wanted to give him a hard time. Ebro, just let it go. We're on positive things.
Nah, it's all good.
We lies. Deonnie, stop crying. Everything's good.
I'm gonna come through with a crit pack, and I'm gonna have some t-shirts and some CDs, cause to kind of update you on the content.
No, listen, I've already bought the album.
I appreciate it, man.
I'm gonna get you some music.
I'm gonna get you some music.
You know who's really to blame here? Let's be 100% honest.
Shaka
Zulu.
He knows all of us. Nah.
It is Shaka Zulu. It's really Jeff's fault.
I'm glad finally.
Man,
Shaka Zulu's been. I've been in communication with him for 15 years.
With Raphael Sadiq, man, pick up that album, Catalactica, man. Thank you, man.
Thank you. All right.
What happened to the soul? I'm talking good eating, good season.
Out of in this world, just trying to make it. Everything I see, sometimes I can't take it. But damn, I really miss those times. That soul's on my mind. My
grandma's hands used to usher Sunday mornings, now before Sunday school. I hustle and I'm on it, I can't slow down now. A dollar and a dream in this life you live. You either the dealer or the fiend, leaning horizontal. The acrobats on the cone and they flip. So when them white vans pull up, shouted, we dip. Out of view, could've been a track star at the school, but it took the police just to get that fofo out of you. Dash, sprint, hurt, over those steel gates. They keep us in and keep folk out, but we don't feel safe. As we used to bat when we was in a booster, watching our uncles drink coolers, talking pie for pie bruises over real bones. Now it's sideways toting. How did Bobby Johnson hold it? Pull the trigger till the clip gone. Potato tip, no potato salad. That American pie ain't even snapping.
Out of in this world, just trying to make it. Everything I see, sometimes I can't take it. But damn, I really miss those.